There are two ways to add a form in Squarespace 7.1. You can add it as an actual form or as a newsletter block. Let's start with newsletter block. In a newsletter block, you get a form name, title, description. You can require name field, then it's going to add the first and last name to the form. And you can add a disclaimer. You can also modify the name of the submit button. You should select a storage, and in my case, it's going to be Squarespace email campaigns. We can connect other services as well, such as MailChimp and Zapier. And we even can send the form's data to Google Drive. The newsletter block has verification enabled by default. And also you can turn on and off the reCAPTCHA. Post-submit, you can send people to a specific page on your website, such as thank you page, or you can just submit a post-submit message or post-submit HTML. Let's hit apply. In order to customize the look and feel of the newsletter block, you need to go to design, fonts, click the gear icon, go to advanced, and here you have the ability to modify the fonts for title, description, field, the internal font of the field, button, and footnote. And to modify colors, you need to go to colors, section themes, and edit the section theme of the block. So for example, this white, that's white minimal, and so it shows me the newsletter block color options for this block. Button background color. There are two ways to add a form, a regular form. First, we can bring it up from here by clicking the drop icon and select form. This will give us a full width form. But if you want to get more sophisticated, you can add a form block as a small section. So let's go here, let's go to contact, and here we have some predefined options with the form. Let's connect this one. So we already have this layout built out for us. We can add a little map below, and we can change the width of this form. Make it bigger or smaller. And by clicking the pen icon, we can bring up form settings. We can add a form field, and there are several options available, like text areas, checkboxes, radio buttons, surveys, etc. The storage and the advanced settings are similar to the newsletter block. And for the regular form, and that's the difference with the newsletter block, you can connect an email address and get the form submits directly to your email address without having to connect some external services. And external services like MailChimp, Zapier, are a part of the business or higher plan.